Ramadan starts this Friday. It's a month of fasting, prayer, and reflection for Muslims. But for some with medical conditions, the fasting can sometimes be dangerous. There are things that you can do to stay safe, and a doctor with Health Partners is helping get the word out. Rena has the story.
I never used to go to the doctor. I am not a doctor's person.
It was 8 years ago that Nizam Hussein was fasting and praying and falling asleep at work. It's what finally prompted him to go to the doctor. Good thing, too, because Nizam had high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, and heart disease. He ended up having triple bypass surgery, so these days, Ramadan looks different for him.
I realize that I can't fast now. Because,
the same is true for many Muslims, but getting people to go against religious tradition is hard.
During Ramadan, a lot of our patients fall into a trap, and we have had a few patients who have had very serious side effects, including some of them who almost died from hypoglycemia, which means low blood sugar.
Dr. Salahuddin Malim with Health Partners says there are groups of people who are exempt from fasting, like the elderly, those with chronic medical conditions, and pregnant or breastfeeding women. But for those who still insist, Dr. Malim says it is important to have a conversation with your doctor.
There are specific guidelines from American Diabetic Association on what kind of medications patients can safely take, which ones they cannot, which one needs to be adjusted.
And remember, fasting isn't your only option.
Instead of fasting, I'm paying charity one meal per day for the month of Ramadan, and I pay that to a person who cannot afford a decent meal. By doing charity, it compensates for where I am lacking in my religious duties.
Rena Sargentopoulos, Care 11 News.
Well, we have a link to fasting protocols from Health Partners and the International Diabetes Federation. You can find them with this story on care11.com.